Enjoying Life with Friends. HSL, the chair specialists, sponsors of Countdown.
Good afternoon and welcome to the Countdown studio. Now, tonight, down in London's Park Lane Hotel, there's a charity Christmas stocking auction for celebrities. And it's all in aid of that wonderful charity, Macmillan Cancer Support. Now, I guess at this time of the year, right across the country, there are all sorts of charity auctions going on, but Christmas stockings. Now, I remember when we were children, little children, the stocking, which was normally... nothing to do with the stocking, really. I wish it were, because they were rather longer. But it was a sort of a long sock, which would be filled with all those traditional things, tangerines or clementines rolled up in silver paper and bits and pieces like that. And it was always great fun. And then poor old Dad used to struggle in, sort of dressed up as Santa, and we'd all pretend not to see him, to embarrass him, and there we are. But it was good fun, wasn't it? It was lovely. And it is wonderful, actually, when Santa does creep in, and in the morning you wake up and he's got around the whole world overnight, filling little children's stockings. I think it's fantastic.
I went to Reykjavik, and I think in Iceland they have something like 12 Father Christmases, so that one starts at some point in December and they just carry on, which makes much more sense. I think they've worked it out. It's a secret. There's 12 different Santas.
That's the way
it works. To get around the world, yeah.
And all those reindeer, too.
Of course.
All those reindeer. Brilliant stuff. Now, who's with us? John Shaw's back from Swaddling Coat. 6 great wins. Well done, John.
Thank you.
Well done. And 2 more wins and you'll be an octo champ. But first of all, you've got to clamber past Paul McLaughlin, a radio producer from Coventry. Welcome, Paul.
Hello.
Welcome.
There.
And for a time, you worked in a prison for young offenders,
that's
I think.
Right,
what
yeah.
was your job there?
Just looking after, I was a training officer, so I'd look after a unit full of young offenders. It's quite hard work, really, but thoroughly enjoyable.
It is, and of course, so many of these youngsters, you know, perhaps they just took the wrong turning and and then before you know where you are, or they are, rather, you know, they're getting into deeper trouble. And did you find that you were able to sort of, you know, talk to them and perhaps knock some sense into them in the gentlest possible way?
Well, yeah, the more time you spend with them, the more they get to know you and, you know, you try and, you know, guide them down the right route and fingers crossed that they've taken on
Indeed.
Your advice, but who knows?
Well, I hope you both have a great contest today. Big round of applause for John and Paul McLaughlin. And Susie Dent over there in the corner, of course. And he not only loves sport, but words and numbers too. That's why he's here at Countdown. Yes, it's Colin Murray. Welcome back. We'll talk to you a little later, but now it's John Shaw's Letters Game. John.
Hi, Rachel.
Hi, John.
Can I have a consonant, please?
You can, thank you. Start today with N.
And another.
M.
And a third.
S.
Can I have a vowel, please?
U.
Another vowel.
O.
And a consonant, please.
W.
Vowel.
E.
A consonant.
T.
And a final vowel, please.
And a final A.
And here's the countdown clock. Yes, John?
7.
And Paul?
6.
That's 6?
Women's.
Yes.
Outswam.
I think you can outswim in the dictionary. You can. We are not allowed apostrophes, so we can't have women's, I'm afraid. Oh. We could have women, Paul, but not women's. Women. Sorry.
OK.
Now then, Yes, Colin.
Well, the question on everyone's lips is, what do you call a mountain under the sea? Susie's going to tell you.
It's a seamount.
Seamount.
A seamount, really?
Yes. Yeah.
Anything else?
No, that's our best for eight. The snow is there for a nice four. Christmassy four. Snow.
Thank you for that. All right, 7 points to John. And Paul, it's your letters game.
Hello, Rachel.
Hi, Paul.
Consonant, please.
Thank you. Start with P.
And another one, please.
B.
And a third, please.
N.
And a vowel, please.
O.
And another one.
E.
Consonant.
L.
Consonant.
S.
A vowel.
U.
And a final consonant, please.
And a final H.
Stand by. Yes, Paul?
Just a five.
A five. John?
Six.
And a six. Paul?
House.
And?
Blouse.
Blouse.
Yep. Yep.
Blousy. Colin?
With six.
Well, let's see how many rhymes we can get in today with Christmas words in every rhyme. So we're going to go two. Noels for five.
Noels.
So
yes.
Snow and Noels. So let's
you see. You can have them with a small N in meaning a Christmas carol. So you can put the S on. Yeah.
Well done. Anything else?
We had a six in phones. Do we have anything above a six?
No, phones and bushel.
Bushel.
Two sixes.
Well done. Thanks, Colin. Now then, John on 13, Paul yet to score, but bags of time. Let's have a numbers game, shall we, John?
Yeah. Can I take one from the top, please, and five small?
You can indeed. One from the top and five little. Thank you, John. And for this round, they are 1, 7, 10, 2, 4 and 100. And the target, 662.
662. Yes, John.
I've got 662.
You have 662, Paul.
I think I've got 662 as well.
All right, John.
Okay, I did 7 times 100.
700.
4 tens of 40.
Yep.
And take it off.
660.
60 and add the two.
Perfect. 662.
There we go. And Paul.
Yes, I did it the same way.
Just showed to John there.
Yeah.
That's good. All right. Well done, Paul. Well done. 23 plays Paul's 10 as we turn to our first tea time teaser, which is asset full. And the clue, it sounds like the perfect performance on the tennis court. It sounds like the perfect performance on the tennis court.
HSL, the chair specialists, sponsors of Countdown.
Armani Code Perfumo, the new intensity, Giorgio Armani.
Wherever and whenever you take a Lindor moment, it just seems to make life feel so much more sublime. Smooth melting Lindor. From the Lindt Master Chocolatier, you choose the moment, we'll provide the bliss.
Want a party?
Yeah! Looks like some babies getting made tonight.
Not here on company property.
Who wants to party with Santa?
This Christmas, make the most of those special moments with PhotoBox. And make someone's Christmas. Bake it. Make it. Photobox it. 1, 2, 3.
"'Twas the night before Christmas. Carrot gazed at the sky, thinking I could meet Santa when he gets his mince pie. But a Christmas he spread, though a joy to us all, can be quite scary when you're 3 inches tall. Still he soldiered on bravely, though exhausted, methinks, as he said to himself, 'Just a quick 40 winks.' And the sleigh flew much faster that cold Christmas Eve, powered on by a carrot, we like to believe.
At EE, we've built the UK's fastest network. And when you put it together with the new iPhone 7, it's a powerful combination. With its incredible new camera, you can take and share great low-light photos, so you can do all the things you love, but faster. Get the brand new iPhone 7 with 6 free months of Apple Music only on EE.
I'm Elaine Page, and this is my personal selection of the very best of the musicals. Three CDs of my all-time favourites from hit shows like Aladdin, yes, love, Aspects of Love, Wicked, Beautiful, Cats, and Chess. Elaine Page presents the musicals. The perfect gift for Christmas.
I'm moving slow. Our hearts beat so fast. Hey, my head is a jungle, jungle.
Black Opium, the feminine fragrance, Yves Saint Laurent.
Paddington! He's a bear.
I think I've got the hang of things.
Paddington's been kidnapped!
No way out.
It's actually quite good fun.
Hand over the bear.
No, he's family.
The network premiere of Paddington, Sunday at 6:15 on Channel 4.
HSL, the chair specialists, sponsors of Countdown.
Warm welcome back. I left with the clue. It sounds like the perfect performance on the tennis court. And the answer is faultless, faultless. Now then, John on 23, Paul on 10. Well done, Paul. And it's now Paul's letters game.
Consonant, please, Rachel.
Thank you, Paul. T.
Another one, please.
R.
And a third.
S.
And a vowel, please.
I.
And another one, please.
A.
And a third.
E.
A consonant.
V.
Another consonant.
Y.
And another consonant.
And the last one. N.
Stand by. Yes, Paul.
Six.
Six, John.
Seven.
Paul.
Raisin.
Now then, John.
Variety.
Variety, very good. Raisin's two eyes, I'm afraid.
Of course it is.
Yeah.
Now, Colin, what have you got over there?
Yeah, variety, varsity, there's loads of sevens. Ravine.
Ravines. Ravines. Yes. Yes, a whole bevy of sevens from
well
us.
Well done. All right. 30 plays 10, and we turn now to John. John, letters again.
OK, can I have a consonant, please, Rachel?
Thank you, John. G.
And another one.
D.
And a third.
F.
And a fourth.
S.
Okay, have a vowel, please.
O.
Another vowel.
U.
And a third one, please.
I.
Okay, consonant.
Q.
And a final vowel, sorry.
And a final A.
And the clock starts now. Yes, John?
Six, I think.
Six. Paul?
Five.
And your five?
Goads.
Goads and?
Quiffs, Quiffs. Q-U-O-I-F-S.
No, not there. Quits are there, but not quiffs, unfortunately.
Bad luck, but good try. Now, Colin?
We sat back there because we don't think there is a six, certainly, that we can find.
No, we were hoping for audios. But it says math noun. So we start with audio for five, quads for five.
Quads.
Five was top from us.
Yeah.
30 place 15. Now, Paul, your numbers game. Good luck.
OK, can I have one from the top, please, Rachel, and any other five?
Thank you, Paul. One large one. And five little ones. And this time the little numbers are 9, 7, 9, 5, 6, and 50. And the target, 303.
303. One away. How about John?
303.
All right, John?
6 times 50 is 300.
300.
9 divided by 9 is 1.
Yep.
7 minus 5 is 2. And add them all together.
303, lovely.
Very neat, John. Well done. Well done indeed. So, John's still in the lead, 40 to 15, as we turn to Colin. And Colin, curses and superstitions in the sporting world today. What have you got for us?
Well, so far there's been something to laugh at, hasn't there? You know, chicken bones being buried or goats being taken into matches. Today, I'm going to give you what I would say is a morbid curse, an eerie curse, and I think the ultimate unpalatable curse, because even if you support this team, you want to break that curse, but you kind of don't want it at the end. I'll get to that in a second. Let me set up. It was 1951, and Mayo were playing in the Gaelic football All-Ireland final, which they win. Buoyant on their way home. They've won the big one. The Sam Maguire trophy's on the bus. They're having drinks, and they're celebrating boisterously. And they go through in the bus a tiny town called Foxford. Very few residents. And there's a funeral cortege. Oblivious to this, they party through the cortege, upsetting the family. And the priest puts a curse on them. And I'll get to the specifics of it at the end. But from then, there has been the most remarkable run of bad luck and misfortune for Mayo. The curse of Sam Maguire. And since 1951, they've reached the All-Ireland final 8 times and have never won it. 1996, some rotten luck against Meath. And literally, just a couple of months ago, it happened again. They lost by the smallest margin you can lose to Dublin in the most recent All-Ireland final. 1 point, and all talk was that the curse wouldn't be broken. It's the curse itself is why I call it the unpalatable curse. What the priest said that day as they goaded him from the bus was, you will not win another All-Ireland trophy until every member of this team has passed away. Now, that's a completely different kettle of fish. Mm. So that's why I say, if you're a fan of Mayo, you might want to break it and prove the curse wrong, but you'd never wish the curse to end.
Quite.
It makes it unique. There's two members of the team who are still alive.
Mm. Quite chilling, that one. You know?
Mm-hmm.
And our Catholic priest would say that in the middle of a...
Yeah.
Well,
it was 1951.
Thank you very much indeed. Good story. And 40... John's 40 plays Paul's 15 as we turn to John for letters again. John.
OK, can I have... Hey, consonant, please.
Thank you, John. S.
And another.
T.
And a third.
R.
And a fourth, please.
M.
A vowel.
E.
Another vowel.
I.
And a third vowel, please.
U.
A consonant.
D.
And a final consonant, please.
And last one, P.
Countdown. Yes, John.
Eight.
And eight, Paul.
Six.
And that six?
Stride.
Stride and?
Dumpiest.
Yeah. Very good.
Dumpiest.
Very good.
Well, well. Yeah. Dumpiest. Now then.
Oh, yay. He burst a balloon there. He popped their bubble. We were all very excited, weren't we?
Yes.
We've seen. But you could say dumpiest and stumpier.
All right. Well done. Well done. 48 plays 15. Paul, letters game.
Consonant, please.
Thank you, Paul. C.
Another one.
T.
And a third.
J.
A vowel.
A.
And another one, please.
O.
And a third.
I.
A consonant.
N.
Another one.
R.
And another one, please.
And the last one, N.
And here's the countdown clock.
Four.
And John?
Seven.
And a seven. Paul?
Torn.
Now then.
Janitor.
And janitor. Well done. Is he still in your thunder?
It's so frustrating. I'm someone who's won six in a row on, isn't it? Yeah. I'm on fire here and he keeps putting them out. Yes.
All right.
Janitor.
Well done. All right. Anything else?
Contain is also there for seven.
And contain. All right. Now, 55 plays 15 and it's John's... Numbers game. John.
Can I have four from the top, please?
You can indeed. Thank you, John. Back to four large and two little. And for this test, they are 10 and 8. And then the big ones, 25, 75, 50, 100. And the target, 782.
782. Yes, John.
I have 784.
Two away. Paul?
783.
783. Paul McLaughlin.
10 times 75 is 750.
750.
Plus 25 is 775.
Yep.
And then add the 8.
Yep, one away. 783.
Well done. Good man. But 782, Rachel, can you crack that for us?
Yeah, a couple of ways. One, you could have said 75 minus 25 is 50. Divided by 50 is 1. And then 100 minus 199 times by 8 is 792. And take away the 10, 782.
Well done. Well done, Rachel. So 55 for John, Paul on 22, as we turn to our second tea time teaser, which is Yob Finder. And the clue, you don't want a yob. You're looking for a nice man to settle down with. You don't want a yob. You're looking for a nice man to settle down with.
HSL, the chair specialists, sponsors of Countdown.
Unexpected situation, new magic retouch. 3 seconds to flawless roots. 3, 2, 1, roots gone.
Oh, you're home.
New L'Oreal magic retouch.
The new feminine fragrance, Yves Saint Laurent.
The traditional upright vacuum. It's designed to clean everywhere. But is there an easier way?
The attachments shackle you to the vacuum, the cord tethers you to the wall. And there's got to be a better way to do the stairs.
So I designed the new G-Tech Airamp for the floor and the G-Tech Multi for the rest. Two lightweight vacuums,
one powerful combination that gives you high-performance cordless cleaning on the stairs, in the kitchen, and the car.
Don't forget the back seats.
With no cords to hold you back, you get up to 60 minutes powerful cleaning. The Airam's new airlock feature picks up big bits from the surface and fine dust from deep down. While the Multi's powered brush makes quick work of embedded pet hair. Talk about teamwork. And when you're done, the new Airam empties with a slide.
Simple. Order your G-Tech Airam and Multi together.
For £299 with free delivery. Call now or find out more at gtech.co.uk.
Son, I'm sorry I can't make a dinosaur birthday cake. I'm sorry Sheriff Pete gives you sleepless nights. Sorry I'm no rocket scientist. And that one of the wise men was a werewolf. So when there's something I can make, I'll make it special.
Thanks, Dad.
Bring out the Branston and make your Christmas extra special with our Branston Chutney range.
We don't do things like that around here.
We do things proper.
It might look like a little bit of litter, but little things matter.
We choose the square tea bag and follow that star. However hopeless, no matter how far from Harrogate it may take us.
And why?
Because this, my friend, is Brutopia. This is proper. This is Yorkshire.
One day I'll fly away, leave all this to yesterday.
I will make your heart beat, sometimes break. You never know where I live, where I stay. I'll be no angel. Now you know.
Diesel Bad, the new fragrance for men.
My water just broke.
Yep, I found him. My father.
You're the only good thing in my life.
Not that great.
I know.
You want to be fat friends?
You want to meet your grandchildren?
You took the sourest lemon that life has to offer and turned it into something resembling lemonade.
Brand new drama, This Is Us, starts tonight at 9 on Channel 4.
HSL, the chair specialists, sponsors of Countdown.
Welcome back. A warm welcome back. I left you with a clue. You don't want a yob, you're looking for a nice man to settle down with. And the answer to that one is you're looking for a boyfriend. boyfriend. So 55 to 22, Paul, your letters came.
Consonant, please, Rachel.
Thank you, Paul. R.
Another one.
D.
Another one.
M.
And a vowel.
E.
Another vowel.
U.
And a third.
E.
A consonant.
N.
And another consonant.
C.
And another consonant.
And lastly, W.
Stand by. Yes, Paul.
It's five.
Five, John?
Six.
Paul.
Renew.
Now then, John.
Mender.
Amender.
Yes.
Can we beat it, though?
My word matches my performance in that round, which is dunce. but not Susie.
Susie?
crewmen is there, are there, for seven. Crewmen.
Crewmen. Well done. Yeah. All right. So, John, letters game.
OK, can I have a consonant, please, Rachel?
Thank you, John. R.
And another.
L.
And a third, please.
P.
Vowel.
I.
And another vowel.
A.
And a third.
E.
A consonant.
T.
Consonant.
R.
And a final vowel, please.
And a final I.
And the clock starts now. John?
Seven.
A seven, Paul?
Six.
And your six?
Repair.
Repair. John?
Platter. P-L-I-A-I-T-E-R.
Absolutely fine. Yes.
We're back with platting, are we?
Plating.
What have we got there, Colin?
I can just match seven. Partier?
Yes, you can be a partier. Yep, you can.
I party more?
Yes.
Yeah.
Oh, as in you are a partier.
Oh.
He's somebody who loves to party.
Right, there you go. Does a job, which, you know.
We got that.
What can I say?
And Susie?
There is a note there, Nick, pre-trial.
Pre-trial, oh, yeah. Yeah, you go and give the judge your arguments just to make sure that there is a case, a pre-trial.
Exactly.
All right, 68 plus 22. Susie, what have you got for us today?
I have, having a gander, because I was emailed by John Butler, a viewer, who says, you know, Why do we have a gander when we take a look at something? A bit of a hallmark of Cockney English. So you might expect it to be rhyming slang, but actually it's not in this case. So I'll start with gander itself. And the meaning of a male goose goes back to the earliest days of English, so we're talking Anglo-Saxon times. But if you jump forward to the 16th to the 19th centuries, a gander also became a byword for a stupid person, a fool. And there are quite a lot of examples where animals obviously are given characteristics, stereotypical characteristics. Many of them actually are given the unpalatable, if you like, or not very nice characteristic of being silly. So we have a silly a goose, a stupid cow. Jaywalking goes back to the silly nature of the jaybird, as legend would have it. But I mentioned silly goose there, and actually that was one of the first meanings of gander, a stupid person, a simpleton, if you like. So not seen as being particularly intelligent, perhaps rather aggressive and headstrong. But curiously, at about the same time as we had this this insult, if you like, gander also became slang for a married man, especially one who didn't live with his wife, or certainly one who wasn't particularly faithful. So a gander party was the early form of a stag do, but a gander month, or a gander moon as it was known, was one in which a man was permitted to let his eyes wander. And the idea was that his wife could rest for a month as if she was laying eggs. Perhaps an allusion... allusion to the goose's apparently aimless wandering during this time, during the nesting season. So this is a rather circuitous history of gander. To gander was a verb in the 1600s, and it meant, following up on that idea of the gander month, it meant simply mooching about, so sort of wandering slightly aimlessly with a rather vacant look on your face. So it was quite a pithy word, but only later did it come to mean stretching your neck out like a gander. So like the male goose, to stand and gaze at something. Again, this idea of sort of vacancy and not really concentrating on something. So very, very long, complicated history at gander, but foolishness is at its heart.
Fantastic. Oh, lovely. Is that good? That's lovely. So let's go and have a gander.
Yes.
They're brilliant.
Let's crane our necks.
That really is superb. Thank you, Susie. 68 plays 22. And, Paul, it's your letters again.
Consonant, please.
Thank you, Paul. T. A
vowel, please.
A.
Another vowel.
I.
And a consonant.
L.
And a another consonant.
D.
And another one.
G.
A vowel, please.
E.
And a consonant.
R.